All right, this is part two of the enclosed trailer build. So from where we left off last time, the only thing I really did was I took the wiring harness and just bunched it together there. So today's plan is going to be grind all the scum off here, and after that give it a nice coat of paint everywhere except the front where we're gonna have to weld some vinos, some brackets for the vinos here, and the rest should be painted, grinded down, and that should be today's goal. So here's what I bought to do most of the work today on these this grinding job. I don't know how it's gonna go. Never used these before, but I got this one, which is like hard, just wire, and then this one I'm assuming is for finishing. It's a lot softer. And then for the really nice stuff, I also got this, which is a sanding disc. So we'll start with that and see how it goes. So what you saw me get there was all I could get with that tool on the grinder right there. So what we're gonna do for the rest of it is we're just gonna scruff it up with one of these. And remember, when you're doing this, the only really thing you're doing is trying to take off any chippage or anything that's really hanging off, because the paint we're gonna put on this is made to go on rust. So you don't really have to go down to bare metal. All you're really doing is scuffing it up. All right, so here's the rust paint I got at Canadian Tire. It's like I said, it's just some regular paint that is literally made to go over rust. So I'm gonna start by painting all the underneath and then let it dry, come back tomorrow, I guess. Came up pretty good. So I'm just gonna have to let it dry, I guess, overnight. I'd say to just use like about this much, not even. So that's a 946 milliliters. So you should be good for your whole trailer if that's what you're doing. And that was about $15. And this brush, from experience, don't even try to clean it. You're just gonna muck up your hands for one, and two, you won't be able to use it tomorrow. So I'm gonna put it in a bag, see what it does. If it's good, it's good. If it's not, well, out it goes. Anyway, I buy, as you can see there, it says gold on it. That's the dollar store brand. I don't know what I paid for it, but it wasn't much. So another tip that I can give you is I have this to sand down. Don't sand it down. Wait until this dries. Tomorrow, when we do the other side, we'll sand it down and paint it at the same time. All right, so I went ahead and painted the other side of the trailer off camera, since grinding and painting isn't really the most fun thing to watch in the world. So now that we got that done, we can start on welding the vinos. I went and borrowed this Miller welder from one of my buddies. So what we're gonna do now is we are going to put this vinos. I got some of the dimensions here. I measured it all up beforehand. So that's what we need to cut. And I had these rails here from the trailer before. These were the sides of it. So I'm going to try to reuse as much of this steel as possible. So let's start cutting and welding shit together. So this triangle piece is finally all welded up, welded on, nice and solid. So all that's left to do with that is give it a nice coat of paint, then we can put the plywood on and start doing the framing. That's going to be in the next episode though. The only thing left to weld right now is this, I guess you could call it like some kind of coupling or something. And those holes align, so when those and those are aligned, the jack's up. When the side ones and those are aligned, it's down. So I'm going to have to weld this on somewhere here and make sure it doesn't interfere with that. So that's what we're going to do right now.
Store begging for your change. I'm drinking from a kid named Tom who said he was in love. Said, don't worry about a thing, baby, darling, the man you've been dreaming of. But 3 months later, he said he won't date or return a call. And she swear, goddamn, it's funny, that man cutting off his balls. And she heads for the clinic and she gets some static walking through the door.
There's another good day's work. We got the Vinos finally all welded up and finished, painted and everything. And I mean, for an amateur welder, I find it came out pretty nice, so I'm pretty happy with that. And I also put that little round thing for the jack, so that's nice. And I did this off camera, but I went ahead and passed all the wires underneath the trailer, so once we get all the sides up, all we'll have to do is start from there. We won't have to go underneath anymore. So basically the only thing underneath left to put is the axle, which we're only going to do at the end. So from here on out, it's all up top. So yeah, thanks for tuning into this episode, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you liked it, leave a like, subscribe, and comment if you have any questions. Thanks, see you next time.